हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सेकंड लेक्चर ऑफ मैमलियन हिस्टोलॉजी। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी द इंट्रोडक्शन टू द हिस्टोलॉजी। इट इज़ आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर एंड दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू सी द डेफिनेशन एंड द स्कोप। सो द पिक्चर यू आर सीइंग नाउ, इट इज द एंथुजियास्ट स्टूडेंट लाइक यू, वन ऑफ यू which are ready to learn all histology. So let's see in our next slide. In this slide we come to know that the all life is started with a single cell. You know what is meant by the cell. These cells are the smallest and structural and the functional unit of processing the properties such as growth, reproduction, metabolism and irritability. So these cells combine to form tissue. We all know that we have these cells group together and form a tissue. Tissue group together and form an organ, and organ form together and form a system, and various system makes our body. Okay, so in first picture you are seeing that the section is taken of a single cell. You are saying you will come to know that there are nucleus, nucleolus, and all other mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, etc. Likewise, in second picture, this is one type of tissue. We are going to see in detail next. This is the grouping of all cells combined together and form a single layer, and this layer is known as a tissue. And the next one is the combination or companion of all tissues, and there are some other tissues also. So those one different type of tissue combined to form an organ and performing same or different function. Okay, so in next slide, so what is histology? There is a question mark that what is histology. Histology means, histos means tissue, logia means to take knowledge or knowledge. That is, histos means we are going to take knowledge of the tissue. It's called histology. These are the Greek word, histos and logia. These are the Greek words. The branch of anatomy which deals with the study of microscopic structures of tissues and organs with their respective function. Here we said that branch of anatomy. Anatomy means what? The your structural lining of your body, how your body is composed of, the structure, the various organs, their structures, etc. is known as anatomy. This is the one branch of biology. It's also called as a microscopic anatomy. It is also called histology, has intimate relations with the anatomy itself or a microscopic anatomy. That are histology's relations with the physiology, histology's relations with the biochemistry, histology's relations with the anatomy, histology's relation with the pathology, and so on. So we are going to see in broad way what are the concepts and the what are said in that. So there is one question for every student, why we are studying histology. तो व्हाई टू स्टडी एस्ट्रोलॉजी इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू कम टू नो अबाउट हाउ डज द ऑर्गन आर फॉर्म्ड, व्हाट इज द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड हाउ दे आर फॉर्म, हाउ दे आर क्लब टूगेदर, हाउ दे आर वर्किंग, द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ऑर्गन एंड इट्स फिजियोलॉजी एंड इट्स बायोकेमिस्ट्री. If a particular organ, suppose our liver is working, so what is the structure of that liver, what type of cells are that, and how that the cells combine together and how they are work together for forming an organ, we are going to see, or we come to know about what are the relation between them. And what are the biochemical changes or biochemicals which liver releasing, etc. So its relations with physiology, biochemistry, and our anatomy. We can found out correlation between structure and function of an organ. That means we can found out that this structure and its function, what is the correlation in between those two, we can found out that how diseases are formed. So we come to know that so and so disease is happen, so how that disease can be cured. So suppose cancer is there, one of we can take example a cancer. What is meant by cancer is what happens in cancer, the growth limit, that is cancer is multiple cells are growing up, and the cell proliferation is unstoppable in cancer. So how you come to know that this is the so and so type of cancer, and how we are going to diagnose it. So we have to study the correlation between structure, means what type of cells they are and how they are proliferate, or what type of functions they are occurring. So we have to know that structure and function of an organ to come to know that what type of disease is that, and how that disease is formed. How disease tissue differ from the normal ones. Yeah, this is one type. This is a main thing that we come to know, that how normal cell is look like and how disease cell look like. So the proper difference is there. So cell turgidity or cell mass secretion or etc. This we come to know. It is helpful in the diagnosis of diseases. Yes, it is helpful in the diagnosis of diseases also. The objectives of histology course is to lead to understand microanatomy of cell, as we have said that histology is also known as microanatomy of cell, tissue and organ, and to correlate structure with function. As I said earlier, we have to, if we are come to know how normal cells and look like and how disease cell look like, we can correlate structure, function, and it's all things to do better diagnosis. So in the next slide, histology and its techniques, we are going to see that under the topic of scope of histology. So in our laboratory, we will perform some practicals, that the section cutting and etc., or make a slides of the liver or kidney or etc. etc. So we know that the microscopes, there are two type of or more than two type of microscope are there. Light microscope, electron microscope. We know that the light microscope using natural light, and electron it gives several times magnification than the light microscope. In that, first our main point is examination of living cells and tissue without any chemical treatment. So without any chemical treatment means we have to keep that fresh or the normal looking cell and the its natural color. So it will be fresh and uncolored. We take simple cross section or a transverse section. We will keep in that cross section sample into saline solution. We are going to simply take a smear on slide and observe under microscope. There is a one technique like your simple toothpick is curl among the your cheek from inside, and your some tissue it will be live or it will be dead. So your some tissue are stuck on toothpick, and we are just smear on the slide, and we are going to observe under the microscope. So we come to know that the fresh and untreated cells, how they are look like. So there is one in biotechnology, tissue culture is there. So cell or tissue is removed from this from cell or a stem, bark, or even animal cell linings also is cultured. So one cell is taken, and on growth medium aseptic, it's all happen in the aseptic condition on great growth culture medium. It grown and observed. It's you should know the HeLa cell lines. HeLa culture cell lines means what? The cancer in breast, one of the HeLa cell lines are from the cancer. HeLa cell lines are the cancerous cell lines which are which are kept as a control as a for the cancerous studies. So this type of technique are used for the cultivation or the culture medium for the tissues. Organ culture is also done from the same technique. So in next slide, living cells after chemical treatment means there are some vital stains and supravital stains like mentioned here in this table. What are the vital stains? We come over that point. But what are the vital stains? Vital stains are nothing but the dyes which are used in the slide or which are used for the studying purposes. Like vital stain does not kill the cell or does not harm the cell, and it maintain its moisture, its rigidity, and we can use for the study purposes. So there are some basic dyes or acidic dyes. There are some example like methylene green and its color. So you have to in your practical examination there will be some slides kept in over the under microscope, and you have to observe that, and you have to write it. So which stain is used in it and what type of cells would be it is. So you can come to know about that color of that slide or what type of a stain is used in that. Okay, so basic dyes are methylene green, its color is green, methylene blue, its color is blue, is pyronine, and pyronine G and toluene we are not going to use because it's used in the higher studies. And acidic dyes like acidine, fructosine, alanine blue, eosine, we are its color is red. It is used number of times. Orange G, so its color is orange. Likewise, we come to know that on that color, we come to know that how their structure and how their etc. Cell fraction and centrifugation. What is meant by fractioning? Fractioning is known as dividation. Okay. The cell organelles can be separated into layers of a different specific gravity. What is the specific gravity is? If you take one example, like if you are going to massacrate and there will be specific gravity of each cell organelle. It's a specific. So it's molecular weight. Okay. So on the specific gravity that we come to know smear and the other collected parties. So in smear we are going to locate some a cell organelle or that debris which are kept in the bottom of the your test tube. So it's totally divided on the specific gravity. So its own weight. Organelles such as nuclei, mitochondria can be separated, which are called as fractions. Okay. So in next slide, there are some examinations of killed cell tissue. Means we can study them in live, we can study them in without treatment, we can study them in with treatment, we can study them in after killing also. So massacration is nothing but due to treatment in a strong acid or in weak acid, the intracellular substances are removed and individual cells like tissue can be isolated. Means one piece is there, so we have to separate the tissue from that one particular part. So what kind of tissues are there, and we can find out the what type of cells were there, etc. So in massacration treatment, we give the strong acid treatment to some tissues and weak acid treatment to some tissues, and we can separate them or we can isolate them. Second one is corrosion. Due to treatment with strong bases, in massacration we are giving treatment with the acid, and in corrosion we are going treatment with the base, that is the alkaline solutions. That are alkaline solutions is treated for the soft parts are dissolved and the calcareous part are maintained. Calcareous means with the calcium, the calcium material is there. So calcareous part is maintained and the soft part in that means the muscles, the soft tissue muscles. It is used in the scientific studies, like if we are going to study on the snails. Okay, so what you have to do, that the snails with its shell, you have to keep that shell into a basic solution, so that the snail under that that calcareous shell is get dissolved. Okay, and you have, and your shell is well maintained in it. Okay, so it is used in some scientific kind of studies. And the other one, the use of a physics or use of physics in the scientific study of use of physics in biology, like the third one is the radioautography or radioactive substances or radioactive elements or radioactive isotopes, like bombarded on the tissue and form determination of its location, cells and tissues. Okay, this the radioactive elements like carbon 14, H3, iodine, 128 or iodine 131. The histochemical methods are there. We have seen that the intimate relations with the biochemistry or histochemical method, that certain substances have affection to certain chemical and the dye. Okay, if a substance is have affinity with the one particular dye, etc. So likewise, the certain substances have affection to certain chemical and dyes. These affinities are studied in the method, like we have to tag glycogen, ascorbic acid, lipids, steroids, and the enzymes, etc. Fifth one is historadiography. When X-rays are bombarded on the particular tissue or sample, X-rays are used for the photographing it. Okay, you come across of some chest X-rays and etc. We generally our family doctors do. They are using some X-rays photography for finding some cuff in your chest or your trachea, etc. The UV microphotometry. Okay, so UV microphotometry is nothing but the to track genetic material. How they are going to track it? So genetic material is detected by ultraviolet rays as a dark spots in a photo. So you have in X-rays, likewise dark and light spots is observed. Likewise, in histo or UV micro spectrophotometry, the genetic material is detected in ultraviolet rays as a dark spot, dark patches are observed in a photo, indicates their presence of the genetic material. Seventh one is the immunohistochemical method. Immunohistochemical method is nothing but the one sort of type of the antigen-antibody reaction or antigen-antibody test. Like in this antigen-antibody reaction is carried out under the immunofluorescent dye. What are the immunofluorescent dye? Immunofluorescent dyes are they are going to glow in a certain for the UV bombarded rays, or they can be tracked. So immunofluorescent dye is tagged with the some genetic material, and it can be tracked how they can flow, or it can be tracked by wherever in which part they are going, and etc. etc. So these are some chemical techniques and the introduction what about the histology and why we are going to study histology, etc. So in next chapter we are going to study about the tissues. We are going to our main stream to in the types of tissue you have studied in class 11th, I think, and we are going to review it again. We are going to revise it again. So we will meet in the next lecture, and you have to comment your roll number and your name in the comment section. So I will note that your presence, or you are going to see or not looking after it. Okay, so thank you, and we are going to meet in next lecture. Thank you.